What up?
Thank you guys for joining in today. I am BK back at you with another banger. Today, I want to show everyone how to use this tool. It's a service tool called Symbolic Linker. Now, I'm not a professional at this. I've done it in the past. I've never used Symbolic Linker. I've used the make alias in, you know, your Finder. When you open up the Finder, it says make alias underneath a folder. I've used that, or I've just copied a folder and placed it on my hard drive. But I've been doing research, and I see where this Symbolic Linker works a little bit more proficient with Macintosh computers. So I'm gonna go through those steps right now. I already downloaded it, and I'm about to install it. So, you know, I'll put timestamps that you can follow along. And the main purpose for me doing this is because I got a new computer with less storage space than my old computer. And right now I only have 19 gigs of free space out of 500, and that's horrible. So I'm trying to find the best route to fix or solve the problem. So we're going to get on over into my systems and continue on. So we over here on my desktop, Symbolic Linker. Again, the link, I'll try to put a link to it in the description in case you need it. If I right click on this icon right here, see where it says make alias? That's what I'm used to doing, and a lot of you may be used to doing that. But from what I've done research on, I believe this is gonna solve the issue. So there's instructions here. I'm not gonna, you know, read through the instructions. The program is free, so you just download it. You know, you follow along with the instructions. I've already read that. Oh, make sure you back your computer up. Just back your Mac up before you do this. Like, I did that earlier today. It took about 2 hours to back up, because it's the first time I backed it up since I've transferred from a backup to this computer. So it took a little minute to do, but I've done that just in case I mess up. I could go back to the backup and just start fresh. All right, so you want to highlight this link right here, copy Symbolic Linker. In the instructions right here where it says how to install, you want to open up your folder titled library and look for services folder. If there's not a services folder, then you create one. So right now I'm in my Macintosh HD, and there's a folder called services. So within services, I right click and I paste the item. Now the item is in here, right? So once you have that in here, now when you right click services, right here, now it says make Symbolic Link. All right, so once you have that inside of your system, your services, right, you want to make sure you're in your Macintosh HD. You go to library and you go down to services, then you paste that in there, right? All right, so once you got that, you're kind of good to go from there. The next thing you want to do is just find out what is your what's hogging up the space on your hard drive, right? So for me, I'm starting with the MPC expansions. I'm gonna go through everything else and see what it is, but for right now, in the hidden library, if you don't know how to get to your hidden library, you highlight go and you hit option on your computer, and it opens up the hidden library, right? And you click on that, and it opens up here. And you go to application support in that hidden library, and you scroll till you see Akai. And in Akai, right, the MPC, the expansions, it's heavy. So it's 62.65 gigabytes, right? Inside of the Macintosh HD, whenever you buy, whenever you purchase a expansion pack from akaipro.com, you get a PKG or an EXE, and it writes the directory for you. And it sends it here to application support, Akai, MPC, and then expansions. So the expansions go in here, right? The expansions go in here, but the contents, the sounds of the expansions go in contents, right? So that's 30 gigs right there. And then over here, I got 62 gigs. Right? So I have my external hard drive connected. I created a library for the Go library. That's the hidden library. And I created a folder for application support. Now, the reason why I'm putting it in two different locations is because it's gonna be a symbolic link of two different locations, and I wanna know where they are. So I could put them back in their perspective location. All right, so I'm gonna start with the biggest one first. And I'm shook to death to do this because I read some of the comments that it doesn't work with High Sierra, and I'm slowly migrating to what is it, Catalina. I'm gonna go to Mojave before I go to Catalina and see how that works. All right, so I'm gonna make a symbolic link of this entire folder, right? Make symbolic link. Symbolic link can't be open because it is from an unidentified. Okay, so you click OK. For that, you go to System Preferences. You go to Security and Privacy. Right here, you hit Open anyway. Hit Open. I don't know where it went. I don't know where it's putting. Oh, it pulled it to the top. Okay. You see, it made a complete copy of that folder. Well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna delete this one. The one that says one, I'm gonna delete it. And then basically copy the folder that's labeled Akai in this instance. Copy that folder and then go over to your external hard drive and paste it to that location. Now, this is over 62.65 gigs. So, it's estimating between 18 and 17 minutes is bouncing in between. So, I'm going to let it do its thing, and then I'm going to bring y'all back in. All right. So, I've copied the folder over here. As you can see, it says 62.65. What I went ahead and did while that was copying, because I realized it made no sense to do it that way, was I just deleted those sim links that was created originally. But now what I'm gonna do is create a sim link of this. I'm gonna make a sim link of that. And now I have a sim link of this. Well, I feel like it made a sim link twice. I feel like it made a sim link twice just now. But nonetheless, what I'm gonna do is go down here if I could find this folder. Right here. I'm going to delete the folder. And I hope this worked, man. I'm going to move to trash. Right? So now I don't have that. I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste it here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete Symlink from it. So now it's the original folder, but this folder has the, you know, the folder underneath it. I mean, the arrow. And as you can see, it has everything in that folder. So now I can go ahead and I can delete this, move it to trash, and I'm gonna delete ain't no such things as halfway crooks, scared to death, scared to look, shook. I'm gonna delete that. So now supposed to have alright, that's weird. So I might have to restart my computer to check, because it's not freeing up the actual space, which is weird. But I know I did everything correct. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same with this Macintosh HD file. Close out of this. Well, as you can see, though, it says 7.34. Before it was saying 69. I'm not positive what the rest is. But boom. So I'm going to close that. Still let it come. Pause. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy this. Copy. And I'm gonna paste this in here. Paste. That's also going to take a couple minutes, so I'm going to bring y'all back in after that's completed. All right, so now everything's transferred over. I didn't have to reset my computer because it allocated. As you can see, contents is here. The content file has everything from the MPC folder, but it's the Symlink folder. So now, the test is to go into the MPC. We're in the MPC software, and I have the expansions folder open, the expansion browser, and all my expansions, the 809, all the patches are here. All the folders that I've moved from that initial folder, they're all here. So And I know for sure, because the MPC ONESHOTS Volume 2 was definitely in that hidden folder, and it's still here. So that brings us to the end of this. Hopefully I'll be able to edit this video and get it out to you guys by the end of this week, which will be Good Friday. And for those of us that stay to the ending of this video, we're running a sale on bkbangers.com. The sale should be like, you know, 30%, between 30-50%. I gotta check the back end to see what it'll be. But the link for that will also be in the description. You just click that link, take you to bkbangers.com, and you could type in the sale. I'll make the sale code be Good Easter 20. All right? Because we're in the year 2020. It's Good Friday, Easter Sunday, Good Easter 20. And that'll be however much we're taking off of everything that's on the actual site. So if you bang with your boy and you don't got MPC ONESHOTS and Kigu's MPC ONESHOTS Volume 2 or anything that's on bkbangers.com, please do utilize the discount code. It'll only be from this Good Friday up until Easter Sunday. Alright? You guys stay safe out there. Practice social distancing. Wash your hands. Take care of your babies. And do remember that music is life. It is our DNA. Keep banging. Peace, love, and light. Till next time. Also, please be sure to back up your computer before you attempt anything that I displayed in this video. Please don't come back to the video and saying you lost your files. I made sure I backed mine up, so you make sure you back yours up. All right, love and light.